Hello everyone, in this video I'll show you how to install Python using Anaconda on Windows OS platform. Let's get started by downloading the installer from anaconda.com. Please go ahead and click on download. I'll provide the URL to this website as part of the description of this video. While the installer is being downloaded, let me specify why it is essential for every CS220 and CS319 student to follow along with this installation video in order to install Python 3 on your laptops. Even if you have a prior version of Python 3 installed on your laptop, it is essential that you install Anaconda 3 in order to install Python version 3.9 due to a couple of reasons. The first reason is because Anaconda 3 installs various data science packages other than installing Python 3 itself. We'll be using various data science packages throughout the course of this semester, so it is essential for you to install Python 3 using Anaconda 3. The second reason is because we want every student in this course to have the same Python version installed on their laptops as the staffing team for this course. For Fall 2022 semester, we'll be using Python version 3.9 for CS220/CS319 course. So please make sure to follow along with this installation process and get Python 3.9 installed by installing Anaconda 3. Once the installer download process is complete, go ahead and left-click on the exe file. That should launch the installer window momentarily. Let's just wait for the installer window to get launched over here. Once that happens, let's go ahead and click next. Go ahead and click on I agree for the software license agreement. Go ahead and select just me. Go ahead and click next. Let's click next one more time. Make sure to select add Anaconda 3 to my path environment variable. This is despite the common recommendation. Please go ahead and select both of these checkboxes and we are going to click install. Installation of Anaconda is going to take a significant amount of time, so please make sure to pause the video here and complete the installation step. I'm going to pause the recording here and I'll start recording once the installation step is complete. Welcome back everyone. Hopefully all of you were able to successfully complete the installation step. Go ahead and click on next and go ahead and click on next. And let's go ahead and click on finish. I'm going to show you how to launch PowerShell window. Go to the start search bar and type PowerShell. And you should be able to launch Windows PowerShell application. Go ahead and left click on it. Let's go ahead and confirm the installation process here by typing Python. Go ahead and type Python and press enter. You should be able to see this triple right arrow. Notice that the Python version is 3.9.12. Let's go ahead and type exit open parentheses close parentheses and press enter in order to exit from the Python application here. Let me show you how to use pip, which is Python's package installer, in order to install one additional package which is going to enable you to run otter-grader test results for the purpose of projects in this course. That is one package that is not being covered with the Anaconda 3 installation. In order to install that package, go ahead and type pip and type space install, then space otter-grader. Go ahead and press enter. That should start installing the otter-grader package. We'll be using that package in order to run otter-grader test results for the projects. While this installation is going on, go ahead and launch another PowerShell window. You can do that by typing PowerShell into the start search bar again. Once you do that, let's go ahead and type in another command that's going to be jupyter. Note the misspelling. You need to spell jupyter as J-U-P-Y-T-E-R. Then press space and then type notebook. Go ahead and press enter. Jupyter notebook is going to be the key format that we'll be using in order to write Python programs throughout the course of this particular semester. We are going to confirm the successful installation of the Jupyter package. Once Jupyter session launches, it should open a new tab within your browser here. So go ahead and confirm that you're able to launch the Jupyter notebook session. Go ahead and close that tab. Go back to the PowerShell window where you launch the Jupyter notebook session. Go ahead and close this PowerShell window. Once you do that, go back to the other PowerShell window which we were using for installing the Python package otter-grader. Hopefully your otter-grader package installation was successful. This error shouldn't mean anything. Let's go ahead and test the installation. We are going to do that by typing Python. Go ahead and press enter. Let's type import space otter. Go ahead and type enter. If the installation were successful, you should be able to see triple right arrow appear once you type import space otter and press enter. That should confirm the installation for you. You can go ahead and exit by typing exit open parentheses, close parentheses. That'll be it for this installation video.